The presently accepted wave mechanical model describes an atom consists of an extremely small positively charged nucleus surrounded by a cloud of negatively charged electrons, and the electrons in an atom remain in distinct orbitals around the nucleus. Some interpret the electrons in an atom as a series of standing waves or stationary waves around the nucleus. Anyhow, the central idea about the model is that the tiny nucleus of an atom is surrounded by fast-moving electrons, and this high-speed motion counteracts the attraction from the nucleus and prevents the electrons from falling into the nucleus. When an atom absorbs energy, an electron jumps from a low energy level to a higher energy level, that is, from an inner orbit to an outer orbit. This excited state cannot be sustained, so the electron returns to its ground state. This jump causes the energy difference between the two energy levels is released as a photon. The acceptance of this wave mechanical model of atom is essentially based on the proposal of de Broglie's matter wave theory published in 1924 and followed by the experiments conducted by G.P. Thomson and Davison and Germer with artificially accelerated electrons. In their experiments, the electron beams are created by applying high voltages between the anode and cathode in the experimental setup. But today we know that in a hydrogen atom, there is only one force that exerted on its electron, that is the attraction from the nucleus. But this attractive force cannot make the electron in a hydrogen atom in consistent motion, and there is no such a force which can create the so-called matter wave of electron. So the present wave mechanical model of atom is simply wrong. Since there is no motion, there must be a force which prevents the electron from falling into the nucleus. Volume of atoms and elastic nature of atoms. For example, gas atoms move randomly in high speed and bounce back when they collide with other atoms or its container indicate that the nucleus of an atom is surrounded by a form of elastic matter. I name this matter as space matter. So, there are two factors that determine the electron configuration in a hydrogen atom. They are attraction from the nucleus and buoyant force exerted by space matter. The density of space matter is greater at the near surface of the nucleus and it decreases with the increasing of the distance from the nucleus. Watch video Structure of the Atom. The electron in a hydrogen atom is situated in the region where the attraction from the nucleus is neutralized by the buoyant force exerted by space matter. Since each of the different space matter regions with precise radiuses from the center of the nucleus has unique densities, each of those regions act as resonant columns with unique natural frequencies. We can call a resonant column in an atom as a shell. An atom has three types of shells. 1. Electron shells. The electron shells are the shells in which the electrons are configured in an atom when the atom is in non-excited state. Hydrogen and helium have one electron shell. 2. Transitory shells. The transitory shells are the regions in which the electrons can jump from the electron shells when an atom is in excited state. An atom has enormous number of transitory shells in it. 3. Inner transitory shells. The inner transitory shells are the shells that inside of the innermost electron shell. One way in which hydrogen atoms can be excited is by bombarding with electrons in a discharge lamp. When a low pressure hydrogen gas is excited in a discharge lamp, the hydrogen atoms emit its unique spectral lines. Since the density differences between inner and outer regions, when an electron is excited in an atom, for every oscillation towards the direction of the nucleus, the high density space matter in the inner region of the atom expels the electron to an outer low density space matter region. This is the reason for the jumping of an electron when it is excited in an atom. Emission of Lyman series photons. When the electron shell of a hydrogen atom is excited, it will oscillate in its natural frequency, and so the electron present in the shell. This oscillation of the electron causes the emission of the shortest wavelength Lyman series photon and jumps from the electron shell to an outer transitory shell. If there is no further excitation for the atom, the electron instantaneously falls back to the electron shell. The jumping of the electron depends on the degree of excitation of a shell. That is, if the electron shell is extremely excited, for example with a high energy electron, the shell oscillates in the natural frequency of the shell, but the amplitude of the oscillation will be higher. So the electron emits a high amplitude photon in the natural frequency of the shell and jumps to a more outer transitory shell. In the absence of a further excitation of the atom, the electron instantaneously falls back to the electron shell. This fault causes the shell get excited in a nominal fashion and emits a low amplitude photon in the natural frequency of the electron shell and jumps to a nearer outer transitory shell. In the absence of a further excitation, the electron instantaneously falls back to the electron shell. If the nearer transitory shell to which the electron has jumped is simultaneously excited, the transitory shell oscillates in its natural frequency and causes the emission of a Lyman series photon in a longer wavelength. The long wavelength Lyman series photon is emitted because of the low level excitation of the electron shell and followed by the jumping to a nearer transitory shell and the excitation of that transitory shell. Emission of Balmer series, Pascal series, Bracket series and Pfund series photons. The excitation of the transitory shell to which the electron has jumped when the electron shell is extremely excited, the transitory shell oscillates in its natural frequency and causes the emission of a Balmer series photon and to jump to a more outer transitory shell. For every jumping of the electron to a more and more outer transitory shells and the excitation of that transitory shells cause the emission of more long wavelength photons like Pascal series, Bracket series, Pfund series, etc. This process can be continued until the electron is expelled out of the atom and to turn the atom into plasma of hydrogen at very high temperature. Highly pressurized hydrogen gas can cause the emission of a nearly continuous spectrum of radiations when it is extremely excited. This is one of the evidences for the enormous number of transitory shells in a hydrogen atom.